Hello students, today continue with the chapter Fundamental Unit of Life, Cell. We are going to learn today about the very important event in the life of all living organism, that is cell division. Sometimes we accidentally bite our lip or we may cut our skin. But in couple of days, we'll find that, we'll observe that wound heals. Is it magic or something there lying in this? Actually, this is a phenomenon which occurring all the time in our body. And that phenomenon is division of cells or formation of new cells from pre-existing cells. So, where is the need for the cells to divide? Actually, the cells divide to replace old, dead or damaged cells. In human bodies, nearly trillions, 2 to 3 trillion cells divide every day. And some cells, like skin cells, constantly dividing because we are losing skin cells continuously. So, 30,000 dead skin cells we are losing every minute. So, cell division is essential so that this division can replace the damaged or lost cells. Then, organisms grow. Okay, cell division occurs at the time of growth. Cell division is the phenomenon which occurs during the growth. Because when the zygote is formed, from zygote, the complete individual is formed by single cell zygote just by division. Okay, so zygote divides. Then infants, from infants, then reach to the adolescent, and that's all. So, we attain full maturity at the adolescence from single celled by division only. So, the second reason that the cells divide for growth, okay, to maintain surface area volume ratio. What is that? Surface area volume ratio high. We will see in this that yes, the cell, one cell has the surface area. Okay. Now, this surface area has the function for absorption. The surface area has the function for absorption. And to increase the surface area, we all know that cell membrane modifies to form like cilia, finger-like projections and all. So that the surface area can be increased, more and more things can be absorbed inside the cell. Volume, which is actually the space in between, which is present inside the cell. This space is responsible for formation of, the waste product or even the energy also. But the waste products are generated inside that. When the cell increases in size, its area increases, of course, but volume increases more than the area. And for efficiency of a cell, its surface area should be always high than volume. So, surface area volume ratio should be high, and that is why the single-celled organisms like amoeba, they have this demerit in their life cycle that they, not even amoeba, but the cells which are present in our body, these cells, they do not grow beyond a certain size because they have to maintain surface area volume ratio high so that more and more amount can enter inside the cell for formation of new substances. So, to maintain surface area volume ratio high, the cell divides, that give rise to two cells. So, these are the things, these are the reasons because of that the cell divides. Now, cell division, very important event, and in different organisms, the time, that is the generation time of cell is different. We can see the difference like most primitive living organism, bacteria. Okay, so bacteria, example E. coli, it divides its generation time is just 20 minutes. And in human, one cell divides in 24 hours. So within 24 hours, the cell divide and give rise to two cells. Now here is a video which shows you the E. coli division in human cell. Now very interesting one, you can see the cell divides, how the cell divides in the 24 hours time. It is, you know, captured and it is seen only within few seconds. So just now you can see the E. coli and cell division, that is the animal cell. Multiplication of E. coli, 20 minutes generation time in 24 hours. Yeah, that's it. So the single cell divides and give rise to two daughter cells. Now, the types of division. Cell division is of two types. The first type is mitosis. Okay. The second type is meiosis. We just see the definition here and then we will see details of these two processes in the coming slide. So first I will show you what is mitosis. This type of division where chromosome number remains same in daughter cells. Chromosome number remains same. What does it mean? Like in human, when a cell is having 46 chromosome and this cell which is dividing through mitosis, it is actually somatic cell, body cells everywhere in our skin or hair or muscle cell or blood cells, all these, the body cells, actually the somatic cells, soma means body, somatic cells divide and one cell give rise to two daughter cells where the chromosome number remains same. Both the daughter cells will be having same number of chromosomes because it is necessary. Why? Because each species has its constant number of chromosomes. If chromosome changes, if it becomes 45 or 47, then abnormal features will occur. Right? So single cell divide giving rise to two cells having same number of chromosome. And why the similar number of chromosomes? Here is 46, here are also 46, because just prior the division, this DNA material which is present in the chromosome, it gets replicated, it forms its own replica, so it becomes double in amount and then it will be distributed evenly so that constant number of same number of chromosomes which is present in the parent cell will present in both the daughter cell. So the first one, chromosome number remains same and it is present almost all the body cells divide through this division. What is the significance? The wound healing, it is due to mitosis. Growth, it is due to mitosis. Repair and replacement of torn cells, that is through mitosis. Even asexual reproduction in the lower organism is also due to mitosis. So all these processes, they require mitosis. It is also known as equational division. Equational division means the daughter cell is having equal number of chromosomes which is present in parent cell. Now the second type, meiosis. In this type, the chromosome number which is present in daughter cells, it is reduced to half. And this type of division, that is why, because the chromosome number is reduced to half, so this type of division only restricted in our body for the formation of gametes. So this type of division occurs in testes and ovaries in higher animals for the formation of gametes. And we all know that gametes having half number of chromosomes, and at the time of fertilization, these gametes fuse and the number of chromosomes will be restored. Okay, so like in human being, again, the chromosome number is 46. So the when the daughter cells are formed after meiosis, they will be having only 23 number of chromosomes. So this way the egg is formed, this way sperms are formed, and when the egg and the sperm which are formed, they are having 23 after fertilization, again 46 chromosomes can be restored. So the gametes are formed with the help of meiosis. Gametes are also known as germ cells. So germ cells are formed with the help of meiosis. So this type of division first thing occurs in testes and ovaries, and here the daughter cells are having half of number of the chromosomes. Okay, now significance for the formation of egg and sperm, and very important one, to maintain the constant number of chromosome in a species. Otherwise, if the gametes will be having equal number of chromosome, that is 46 46, then the number will become double. The number will become 92. So that will double, and that creates abnormality. So the meiosis is actually occurring in gonads, that is testes and ovary, for the formation of gametes. Now one by one we will see. Yes, this is actually the overall processes, the overview, that the first phase, these are the different phases which are occurring in mitosis. The first phase is interphase. It is a phase between two successive mitotic division. Okay, prophase. Pro means first, so the second is prophase. The third is meta. Meta means in the middle. Okay, so metaphase, then anaphase, right, and then telophase. Telophase, when these chromosomes reach to the opposite poles, and then the cell divides, giving rise to two daughter cells. So here is the telophase and cytokinesis. Okay, now come to the first phase in the mitosis. First phase in the mitosis, that is interphase. Actually, I told you that interphase is the phase which is present between the two mitotic, that is between the two division, okay, two mitosis. Actually, it is, you know, taken as a resting phase, because it is present between the two mitosis, but it is not the resting phase. In this interphase, actually the cell prepares itself for the division. So here the cell organelles divide, the DNA replication, that the DNA gets duplicated, so that, because we all know that chromosome contains information, so the DNA which is having information, so this DNA gets replicated, and this, so that the information should be information can be passed on to the next generation. So information which is present, this information will be doubled because of the DNA replication. So DNA replication, DNA make its own replica, identical copy, and when the identical copy is formed, then the next phases, in the next phases, these copies will be distributed equally. So DNA has the information, so it will get doubled in the interphase. All the cell organelles, because the two daughter cells will be needing all the cell organelles, so cell organelles will be formed. Then the synthesis of the proteins which are required, which are necessary for the cell division, all these substances, RNA, protein, all these substances are formed here. And one more thing, that is the centriole. This centriole gets duplicated, so that one pair of centrioles are present. So one pair will go to the opposite side, and two opposite poles will be having one pair of centrioles. It will be useful for the formation of thread-like structure, which is actually involved to provide the site for the chromosomes. That is known as spindle. So, interface where the synthesis of cell organelles, replication of chromosome, replication of DNA, okay, and synthesis of protein. At this stage, the chromatin now becomes like rod shaped structure which are known as chromosomes. So chromosome starts appearing thread like in this, and then the next phase, yeah, when the actual cell division phases starts from prophase. If the cell enters in mitosis, then the first phase, that is why it is known as prophase. Okay, so prophase, chromatin condenses. Look here, actually earlier in the nucleus, the chromatin is actually, when the nucleus is not dividing, it is present in the form of network, chromatin network, and just before the division, this chromatin get condensed, okay, and they form the rod like structure. And these chromosomes are attached, because they are actually, there are two arms. We can easily see here, there are two arms. Why are the two arms present? Can you make out this thing, that two arms? Because just before that division, the DNA make its replica. So one replica here, one replica here. So that is why, see, one DNA was there. After replication, two DNA molecules. And these two DNA molecule, that is known as, each is known as one chromatin. This is attached by the structure which is known as centromere. Okay, so here 1, 2, 3, 4 chromosomes, and each chromosome has two DNA molecule instead of one. So DNA content here double. DNA content is double at the time of prophase, because it has DNA gets replicated in the interface. Okay, so what actually what are the features that mark the prophase stage? Nuclear membrane and nucleolus. This is the nuclear membrane. This nuclear membrane starts disappearing. Nucleolus disappear. Spindle formation. I told you that spindle is formed. So spindle formation with the help of centriole and all these structure you will study in the higher classes. But for up to 9th standard, you just have to understand that the cytoskeleton type structures are formed, and they are capped on places with the help of centrioles. So the spindle fiber starts forming. The chromosomes now appear as rod like structures. By the initiation of that, the second phase, that is the metaphase, in mitotic phase. Meta means in the middle, equator. By the time the cell division reaches to the metaphase, nuclear membrane totally disappear. We cannot see here. Okay, and spindle formation is completed. Okay, the chromosomes now lie on the equator. This equator is known as, there is a plate-like formation here, and this is known as metaphasic plate. So at the equator, the metaphasic plate is formed, then chromosomes lie on metaphasic plate. This is actually, at this stage, the detailed structure of chromosome can be easily studied, can be easily understood. Okay, you can easily understand the detailed structure of chromosome, because chromosome. So this is actually the stage where we can easily study the detailed structure of chromosome and DNA, which, and number also. So chromosome number and structure, detailed structure and number can be easily seen in the metaphasic stage. Now the next stage, anaphase. Okay, it is very short stage, very important stage, because the centromere, two chromatids we have seen in prophase and metaphase, that here is the centromere which joins the two chromatids, these are sister chromatids. Now what happens here? The centromere divides. When the centromere divides, these two chromatids, they separate out. This thing is happening here. These two chromatids, they are separated. And each chromatid now behave as chromosome. Why? Because it has complete information. Because DNA gets doubled. In this, double DNA is there. Each information is double here. So the centromere divides, and one copy of information in one chromatid and the same copy in the another chromatid. So chromatid will be having complete information, and that is why it will now can be, you know, said as chromosome. Okay, so here was the metaphysic plate. When the centromere divides, then with the help of, at the centromere on both the side, there is a structure which is actually known as kinetochore. So spindle is there, which is bound to that kinetochore. It will pull chromatids towards the pole, and these chromatids start moving towards the opposite pole. One member towards the north pole, then the other member to the south pole. So these two chromatids get separated, they are pulled apart, and this is a short phase. They will quickly reach to the opposite poles. So 1, 2, 3, 4 chromatids here, right, and then 4 chromatids here. Now they will behave as chromosome. So we can see in the previous slide, have a look, that here are also the 4 chromosome. Okay, but the DNA content was, DNA was double, but the chromosome number was same. Okay, now what happened here? The DNA now, because the centromere divides, so each chromatid will behave as chromosome, and the complete information is there. So 4 chromosome will reach the chromatid, or chromosome is same now. 4 chromatid will reach to the one pole and 4 another. So the last phase, that is telophase. Here, it is actually the reverse of prophase. This is also known as reverse of prophase. Reverse of prophase means the nuclear envelope again start forming, nucleolus again start, you know, appearing. So these were the incidents that occurred at the time of prophase. Nuclear membrane disappears, then nucleolus disappears, spindle fiber is there. Now spindle fiber disappear, nuclear membrane reappear, nucleolus reappear, and the chromosomes which are here, now they become chromatin like structure. So again decondensation occur, and then the cell divides and forming 2 daughter cells. Okay, so this is the telophase. So we have seen interphase, then prophase, then metaphase, then anaphase, and then telophase. Have a look to all the diagrams here. That was actually interphase. It's written here G2, where the G2 means first phase was in the interphase was G1, then S, then G2. Okay. In S phase, the DNA synthesis was there. Interphase, which is actually the longest phase, so it can be divided into different stages. So this is actually the interphase. Then it enters into prophase. Prophase, where the chromosomes start appearing, nuclear membrane, nucleolus disappears, spindle formation starts. Second one is metaphase, starts where they come and lie on the equatorial plate. And this metaphase is complete, where they are on the metaphysic plate. This will then lead to the anaphase. Centromere division occurs, and the chromatid start moving towards opposite poles. All these will reach to the poles, and then the cytokinesis, that is the cell division occurs. There is a difference in the cell division in plant cell and animal cell that we will study in the next video. Okay, so that's all for the complete process of mitosis. And now it is here is a checkpoint for you. I'm going to ask you the question. Okay. Now, identify the cell. This cell is in which state of mitosis? You can easily make out when the equatorial plate is here and they are arranged on the metaphysic plate. So, here the cell is in metaphase stage. Metaphase stage. Okay. One more question. A skin cell has 24 chromosomes. Not in human being, maybe. Okay. In other living organism, animal. 24 chromosomes, somatic chromosome. How many chromosomes will it have after mitosis? Skin will have will undergo mitosis division. And we all know, then when the cell divides mitotically, then the chromosome number remains same. So, if 24 parent, then the daughter will be having, of course, the daughter will be having 24 chromosomes. So, the daughter cells will be having 24 chromosomes. That's it, children. Thank you. So, for today's class, we have completed mitosis. In the next class, we will study the second type of division, that is meiosis. Thank you so much.